times more people with serious mental illnesses incarcerated in the United States than in hospitals. And the types of behavioral and mental health problems among inmates are becoming more severe. But let's go back and find out more about the origins of this controversial topic. In 1841, Boston school teacher Dorothea Dix, an American activist, visited the Eastern Cambridge jail when she saw the horrible living conditions of the mental ill. Believing they could be cured, Dix lobbied lawmakers and courts for better treatment. Her efforts led to the establishment of 110 psychiatric hospitals by 1880. The system kept growing with 500,000 American patients. However, the facilities were often filthy. Psychotropic drugs and tranquilizers had not been introduced to the market yet. And thus the halls were filled with people in a daze and rambling from their cycles. Also, most of the staffs were unskilled conditioned, and many patients were locked away and never expected to be reintroduced into society. Due to the poor hygiene practices and unqualified workers, these institutions began closing down. A century later, in 1981, under President Ronald Reagan's Budget Reconciliation Act, repealed Carter's community health legislation and established blocks grants for the states, ending the federal government role in providing services to the mentally ill. Federal mental health spending decreases by 30%. This lack of funding also contributes to the mass closing of the mental hospitals. Today we face the question of whether we should put the mentally ill in prison versus the mental hospital. Here's a look at Matt's Pet's ongoing crime investigation and trial. Take a look at it.
Make you feel crazy.
I don't know, just all this up and down and blah 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 and all this crazy stuff. Let me tell you what, man. Let me tell you what. Man, it's crazy.
Hopefully we don't use the actual word.